doing this experiment, we will try to measure the value of E by M of an electron by helical method. So this, in this experiment we will use helical method and we will try to find the value of E by M. So the formula for E by M for helical method, this formula we will be using. E by M is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 13 d square plus l square by n square by lx square into v by I square. So the meaning where I will discuss later on. This is the apparatus which will be using for the purpose of measuring the E by M ratio. So different knobs are there, so there different functions are there. So I will try to explain the function of these knobs. So this knob, first one you can say, in this knob we can measure the length of the line can be changed to spot, because in the CRO, so we are cutting line, so we have to change to spot. So with the help of this line we will try to change the line to spot. So we will be changing the current basically. So these two knobs we are not using, right? These are for measuring the deflection voltage. Similarly, this knob is for choosing x or y plate. You can see this x and y is hidden, so accordingly we can select. This knob is used to measure to give the voltage, accelerating voltage we can give. So you can see from here, from this voltmeter we can measure the voltage also, right? We can see what voltage we are applying. So similarly, whatever the plate we have selected, accordingly length of the line on the plate can be changed with these knobs. Mean this x, if I select x here, accordingly then we can change the length with the help of this knob. If we are choosing y, according to the V we can change. So if the line we are getting on the CRO, so if you want to change the intensity or focus the line, we can do with the help of these two knobs. So these two knobs are basically helpful only to change the intensity and focus. So once we have selected, so don't change it, it is fixed. Similarly, this knob will be, this will be, this wire is basically a power supply to CRT cathode tube. Similarly, these knobs are, these wires are basically supply for the solenoid. So when we are doing the experiment, we are supplying the current, right? We can reverse the current also with the help of this knob. So in this way, different knobs have different functions and we will be using that. And this is the meter we are using. So we must know the least count for the purpose of measurement, because ultimately divisions we should know what is the value of one division. So here least count is 0.02 ampere. Similarly for the voltmeter, this is the value 20 volt. So in this way, these two, basically, you can say voltmeter and ammeter we are using it, and you must know about the least count. Because we have a cathode tube, this solenoid, basically we are putting this CRT in the solenoid, nothing else. We have to slip it inside, right, and nothing else. Similarly, if you want to give the supply, this is the supply. You can say these two knobs are basically connected here. These are the two wires for giving the power supply to solenoid. Similarly, this knob is, this wire is used for basically to give the power supply to the cathode tube, nothing else. Now this will be the, because this solenoid, we have a CRT inside it, will be always placed in the north-south direction. The reason is that so that the magnetic field of the earth should not interfere. That's why we are really placing this in that this direction, so that the magnetic field earth is neutralized here. This is the basically connection for the video for the how we are connecting the solenoid and the CRT. You can see we are putting this for the connection of solenoid. One wire here, one wire here, and same red we are putting here also, and black in the top. Because this is the connection for CRT, right? This is the connection for CRT we are putting. Similarly, this is the connection for solenoid. So in this way, we can give the power supply to the solenoid and the cathode ray tube. This is the way how we are doing the measurements. So first of all, we will moving this knob so that current is zero, right? Then the select X plate. Then voltage will be at 640 volt. We are picking. You can pick any, but we are picking 640. You can pick above 600, 620, up to you. 640 we are picking, right? So when the voltage picked, then what we are doing, we will be changing the length of the line on the cathode tube. So that will be approximately 3 cm approximately that we are picking, right? So that we can shift, because X plate we are picking, so that by from this X shift we can change the length of the line. Similarly, after doing that, then the focus of the line which we are getting on the this CRT, that we can intensify, or you can say focus. These are the two knobs for doing that. Then what we will do is we will try to move this knob so that the line is basically spot on the cathode tube. That is the purpose, right? So then we will note down the reading of the current. That is the reading, right? Then we can measure same for the reverse also, right? So this whole experiment can be repeated for the 700 volt, means you can change this voltage from here to 700 also, and 760 also. So that we can do. We can do this all these things from for the Y plate also. We have done only for X plate, right? But you can select here from Y plate, then the length of the line can be changed from this one. This is the video basically how we are doing the experiment. You can see here, right? This experiment. First of all, we have on the power supply, right? You can see the voltage is there, right? That is basically the 660 approximately. You can see here. So you can see here, the line is there. So the line intensity and focus can be also adjusted with the opposite. Then we are moving this one so that spot is here. You can see now spot is here. Now you can measure the current at this position. Then we can do the reverse also. You can see we are doing for reverse also. So if you can measure the current, then, right, then we can measure also the first direction, right? So that is for the complete one reading, right? Means whatever the voltage you have given, so at that this is the value of current for a spot. So these are the calculations you can see. So these are the voltage we have given 640, 700, and 760, and X plate we have picked, right? Current, the value in the reverse current also, and if you take the average of these are same 58 58 60 60 and 64 64, right? V by I square we have taken, means this is a V, this is the I. So we buy ice cream, we have taken, right? This we have taken because this will be that directly we are using on this formula, right? These are the values of E by M. This is, you can, we will see in the next slide, that is approximately same, but your standard value. You can see here now. These are these. This is a formula we are using, right? You can see here L is there, D is there. What is L? L is the length of solenoid that is given. That is given by the this this by this this instrument, right? This, this whatever the instrument we are using. So for that, that will be length of solenoid that is fixed. Similarly, number of turns are also fixed. These are 3,000 turns. Similar distance of the X plate, because we have two plates, X plate and Y plate, so you can note down the distance of X plate from the screen, that is also fixed, that is given by the this instrument, right? Distance of X plate. Similarly, diameter of the solenoid is also fixed, that is diameter. So now for X plate we are doing a calculation, D scale, L scale, because first we are calculating the D scale, L scale. Similarly, N square plus LX into N square into LX square, that is that part, this that we calculated. Then the ratio, you can see here, that ratio. Then multiply by 5 into 10 the power 13, that is the value, right? This, you do this, these calculation, that is this result. Then V by I square, that V by I square we will directly using, which we have already calculated in the table, right? So for different currents, voltages, you can see here E by M, the value of E by M is this one. This is approximately, this is a constant value we are getting, 1.8 into 10 the power 12, 11. And similarly, this one also same. So this, these are the basically coulomb per kg, that is unit. So similarly, we can calculate the error also, because standard value we know, 1.7. into 10 the power 11, so percentage error, so we can calculate that this is a percentage error, my Z value minus that value divided by Z value. So this was a my Z value, this is a Z value. If you see, the error we are getting is 5%. So same of procedures, you can, if you want to calculate the same ratio for Y blade also, that you can calculate. Thank you.